we're about to experience one of the most unusual hurricane seasons ever. This is due to the fact that not only is El Nino ramping up in the Pacific, but the waters in the Atlantic Ocean are getting much hotter than what they should be. These are both highly impactful yet conflicting signals for hurricane activity that will make forecasting a nightmare for meteorologists. So in this video, we're going to go over all the latest data and determine not only how many storms will form, but more importantly, how many of those will be big problems here in the U.S. If you missed my last video, you might be thinking, what the heck is an El Nino, and how does it affect hurricanes in the Atlantic? Well, in a nutshell, El Nino is when the waters in the equatorial Pacific region start to warm up. This leads to a giant heat dome, which forces the jet stream in the Pacific to bulge northward as a ridge. In turn, this causes the jet stream to actually dip down into the Atlantic basin, bringing strong winds aloft and cold air into the tropics. And we all know that cold air don't belong anywhere near the daggone tropics. The jet stream diving into the tropical Atlantic creates large areas of wind shear, and wind shear is a hurricane's kryptonite. Whenever a hurricane encounters it, it gets ripped to shreds due to changes in wind speeds and their direction with height in the clouds. Think of it this way. Have you ever been in a situation where you're on an escalator and the handrail is moving faster than the steps? Well, if you were to hold on to that handrail for too long and didn't move your feet, your arm would eventually be torn from your body. And that's exactly what wind shear does to hurricanes. It's absolutely gruesome and hard to watch. But the overall point here is that El Nino is typically not supportive of hurricane activity in the tropical Atlantic. But there's a whole other beast lurking out there that may have the exact opposite effect on hurricanes this year. And that's more warm water, but this time in the Atlantic Ocean. Check out these spring sea surface temperature anomalies. The Gulf of Mexico and the Eastern Atlantic are specifically quite a bit warmer than usual right now. And Atlantic Basin water temperatures in the spring correlate pretty strongly to a season's activity overall. I mean, just look at how close the overall warmth is right now compared to spring anomalies before the 2020 hurricane season. And just to kind of refresh your memory a little bit here, 2020 was nuts. It was one of the most active seasons ever. We had a dozen named storms make landfall in the U.S. And there were actually six Category 4 storms. Most notably, we had Hurricane Laura, which made landfall in Louisiana, causing catastrophic damage. And at one point, there were seven tropical systems happening at the same time out here. Now, we can't just look at sea surface temperatures in May and say that this year is going to be an exact repeat of that. But you have to consider the impact it may have on negating the effects of El Nino here. Warm sea surface temperatures are the lifeline for strong hurricanes. The warmer, the better. It takes that really dense, warm energy to generate thunderstorms that are needed for a hurricane. And not only that, once the storm gets going, the condensation within it creates even more heat. At this point, there is nothing that can stop a hurricane when it gets untapped access to its primary energy source. Except for, of course, wind shear. And this is where the forecast gets really complicated. Due to the fact that El Nino will be intensifying, we expect there to be more wind shear in the Atlantic, leading to a lower impact overall hurricane season. But at the same time, due to the anomalously high sea surface temperatures in the Atlantic, we expect more frequent and stronger storms. Also, it's looking more and more likely that the African monsoon will be more active than normal this year, leading to more African easterly waves that will eventually turn into tropical systems in the Atlantic. And once these bad boys get out there, there is no lack of energy for them in the wide open sea. With all that juice, there will be no thirsty storms in the tropical Atlantic this year, I can promise you that. And there should also be no thirsty people, especially in this day and age where it's so easy to stay hydrated with stuff like today's sponsor, Liquid IV, fueling life's adventures. Y'all, it's getting summer outside, and that means it's getting hot outside, and that means we're getting thirsty inside. Liquid IV's hydration multiplier drink mixes are the best way to keep healthy and hydrated. Just one little magical packet of this stuff is gonna hydrate you 2 times faster and more efficiently than water alone. With 3 times the amount of electrolytes than most traditional sports drinks, each mix packet is packed with 5 of the most essential vitamins. And the convenient on-the-go packaging makes it so that anyone can keep hydrated no matter what you're getting into this summer. And Liquid IV's 3-count sample hydration pack is perfect for that. You get 3 different flavors to try out, and you can pick your favorite and just get started from there. In fact, if you click that link in the description right now, you're gonna get free shipping whenever you order one of these things. So go on down there, link at the top of the description, Liquid IV, get you one of these 3-pack hydration packs, and you're gonna love it, okay? If you haven't tried it already, you're gonna love it. If you've already tried it, you know you love it. Let's go ahead and snag one of those 3-count hydration packs today, and then let's get back into the video. Now, if the resulting trough from El Nino stays in place for the majority of the season, we could see see a situation where many storms form, but they get deflected away from the U.S. in a recurve pattern. However, this is the daggone weather. No pattern, no matter the source, is completely static or permanent. So there will be moments throughout the hurricane season where any storm that forms in the Atlantic will have the ability to come in contact with the mainland U.S. So it's easy to see why this is one of the most unique hurricane season setups we've had in a while, and why it's going to be really hard to forecast. But that don't scare me, and neither does it scare the National Hurricane Center, which actually just recently published its official hurricane outlook for 2023. So let's jump into what you actually came here for. How many hurricanes are we going to see this year? Right now, we're thinking anywhere between 12 and 17 storms will get strong enough in the Atlantic to be named. And by the way, here's a list of those names for this year. On the low end, we expect to only get to Lee, but not all of these tropical storms will become hurricanes. In fact, we only expect around 5 to 9 of the tropical systems that form to actually become hurricanes. And that's actually a pretty normal amount of hurricanes for any given season. This should be expected whenever you have so many conflicting patterns that are leading to this result. If El Nino wasn't in the picture, these numbers would be higher. And if the African Monsoon wasn't in the picture, these numbers would be lower. There's just so many variables that are pointing towards this season being somewhere in the middle of the road. And the official forecast for major hurricanes this year is anywhere between 1 and 4. Now, at first, that might sound low, but remember, it only takes one. Remember last year? It was pretty quiet, and then boom, Hurricane Ian was a literal catastrophe in Florida. It's also really important to point out how out of the 5 to 9 hurricanes that are expected to form this year, up to close to half of those could become major hurricanes. This is because of those warm sea surface temperatures in the Atlantic and the ability for the entire basin to explode with activity if given a break from the wind shear, even for a short period of time. In my opinion, we should be preparing for the worst and hoping for the best. On the hopeful side, El Nino should provide a pretty good chance for a mostly quiet season. I would love to go a whole year without any devastation along the Gulf Coast or the East Coast regions. However, on the cautious side, this is still hurricane season. Just because one thing might lead to decreased activity doesn't mean that we should let our guard down. Can you imagine if the weatherman said there's a slightly decreased chance of rain this summer and you just didn't build a roof on your house because you might not need it? That's exactly what overlooking this hurricane season would be like. Now is the time to go over your hurricane plans, evacuation routes, and have meetings with your family members and coworkers to talk about what you're going to do whenever that cone of uncertainty starts pointing at you. And of course, you should subscribe to this channel because we're going to be covering hurricanes like never before. We're going to have storm chasers out there, live radar analysis, weather surveillance camera networks, science missions, and more. So hit that notification bell right now so you never miss an emergency live stream. Okay, that's all the weather I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Super big shout out to our members out there. And of course, I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.